from the two platforms. One is from the Facebook. One is on the Instagram. So at the both the places, both the viewers can see us. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, what's your plan? What are you planning, Ganesh? What we are planning, basically, not you alone. What we are planning.
We're basically planning to combine the power of graphology with NLP, so that they can come together, and not only we can see what issues people are facing with as a kind of reporting tool using graphology, and attack the root area using NLP, so that they get accelerated benefit, and we can reconfirm that change has taken place by looking at their handwriting again after a period of, say, like 1 or 2 weeks, or maybe 3 weeks. Because graphology is a great tool to understand what the person is facing, because basically the subconscious stuff is revealed very clearly, and with the expertise that Sudhir has, he can go into the real detail of understanding where that originates and whether there is any family connection, whether any members of the family have contributed to that, and particularly the parents.
So you were the fan of NLP. You know, you have learned NLP from so many years. You were, it's like you had the taste, had the run, or, you know, you learned it by rules, you played it by your heart, you have done everything, whichever possible thing is there, you know, in NLP. So when the first time you started exploring graphology, so what was your perception and how it changed along the way?
See, my perception was initially, I was not very sure that you can go to this level of depth using graphology. I thought, yes, it can identify some of the traits, but I was unaware of the kind of traits that you are capable of looking at. Because the traditional graphology, my connection with graphology was, I bought a book many years back, 20, 25 years back in US. I was fascinated that a handwriting can reveal some of the characteristics. So some of the characteristics which I remember was like intelligence. You can say whether the person is sharp or not, and so on and so forth. But as I interacted with you and understood the effects of graphology, I could even go to the depth of understanding as to whether a person has got parent support, mother or father, or whether he has got some issues in terms of hatred or revenge against somebody. And we can even understand whether the person is a good worker, employee or not. So I was quite fascinated. And in my own case, I remember looking at some of my characteristics related to health and implementation related to the health in terms of exercise. Fortunately, I got a gift of having a very slim body.
Okay.
But however, I was not doing enough exercise because I thought that it was not really required. But when I noticed that, like, I'm missing out on some of the health benefits that could come because of exercise, and my mentor also suggested that I go for a 5-kilometer marathon. So that is the time I took your help and changed and implemented some of the changes that you suggested. And I noticed immediate improvement. And I finished the 5-kilometer marathon in almost like 3 weeks' time. From the time I registered, to the time I implemented, 3 weeks. And I completed the 5-mile marathon, and 50% walking, 50% running. But that is my first marathon in my whole life. So compared to that, I was literally filled with energy after the finishing the marathon. I was not tired. So that was a great improvement for me. So it's a practical proof that the handwriting changes and the results also come. Of course, I use my NLP and HUNA tricks also along with that, so I could achieve this result together.
So when you called me and you said, okay, let's team up and let's combine graphology with NLP. Both are the similar kind of tools, wherein but NLP is different and the graphology is different, but both work on subconscious mind. So what exactly was the insight which came to you because of which you had this kind of feeling, okay, let's start with this, you know, let's combine both the two and give something very unique to our audience.
Right. See, the primary purpose of why somebody looks at graphology or NLP is they want to implement some change. They want to achieve certain goals. So primarily the purpose of a client is they want some change and they're ready to do whatever is needed. So graphology brings awareness, no doubt. And they got to practice. And there could be so many blocks stopping them from achieving that. Number one, there could be a kind of belief which might pull them apart. One of the examples could be a person, let's say like he's in Pune, and he's got a job offer, one from Mumbai, the other one from Pune. Pune, maybe it's low paying, whereas Mumbai, the salary is high. But if he's got to go to Mumbai, maybe he's got to leave his family back in Pune. So job is a common criteria, but there are certain positive factors in Mumbai. There are certain positive factors in Pune. So it is, he's unable to decide which job should I choose. So this, what we call is like parts, different parts of our own mind pulls us in two different directions. So NLP has got a beautiful way of resolving parts. It's called as parts integration. You integrate both the parts, take the good things from here, take the good things from here, combine that, and you make a decision. Basically, your subconscious allows you to make the decision. So what I thought was, we can use graphology as a tool to understand where the person is at and use all the tools, graphology plus NLP, so that combined effect will be phenomenal. And I don't know, maybe there are some areas where NLP is more geared, more easier, and whereas in some areas, graphology could be an easier tool to use to affect the change.
Great. So it's like, let me make you, make our viewers aware about this fact that we are TVML. We are doing a session on 27th and 28th, a 2-day session, full day session will be there. And what we are planning is like, we will give you graphotherapy, of course, graphology knowledge and NLP both. We will teach you techniques. We will put you through some exercises as well. Wherein your challenges, such as, you know, maybe the biggest challenge which today's people are facing is like the challenge of finance, then the health, then maybe organization of life, family. And yeah, what else? What other things are there, you know? Ganesh, what else is we are going to focus on?
Yeah, recently when I heard, I was shocked. Today's the actor committing suicide. See, Sometimes it is not even money. Sometimes it is relationship. It is mental stability. So that is where NLP can play a big part in terms of being comfortable, being happy wherever you are, whosoever you are, because have a path from wherever you are to reach a point which gives you more satisfaction, more money, more happiness, more joy. So we can help you. And in this particular session, which we are going to conduct, we are going to keep it as practical as possible. So you come up with your issues and problems and you walk out having a resolution, solution, and which can already implement.
So one of my mentor used to say, money is the easiest problem to solve, but rest all the problems like health, you don't have any control over it. You know, once your health is bad, you can't do anything about it. So health and then relationship, these two problems are too difficult to handle compared to the money. But a lot of us have this viewpoint that money is the biggest problem, because since you are struggling with the money, since you are not having enough money in your hand, you may feel like that. But you see the today's story, the person has everything, you know, in terms of health, in terms of money, you know, there was no challenge. But there are other areas like relationship, mental issues. So these are the areas we need to be very, very focused about. No, these are the areas which are going to help you to achieve bigger things in life. You know, money is like, you know, you must have seen people losing it all the money from their life and still they were able to recover it. Paisa chala gaya, fir unhe wapas kamaya, fir chala gaya, fir wapas kamaya, then they were able to rise at that level. It is because of the mindset and the relationship. You know, their family was strong with them all the time, and at the same time they had a support from their friends, and then they had the mindset to go and perform the things again and again. So this is what you are referring to, right? Mindset and relationship when we speak.
See, one of the examples which I would give is this, that everybody's got certain identity. Who I am today, there is an identity. And where does this identity come from? From my past, whatever action that I have taken. So you are defined by your past normally. All your behavior, it arises from the past. In NLP, what we can do is we can change the whole equation and you can define yourself from the future. The future is something that you create, and you can ensure that from that future, you design your present day. So you slowly arrive at your future, and we can remove the effect of your past. Maybe it is an emotional issue. Maybe it is certain wrong programming when you are young. So all those things can be kind of neutralized, reduced to a great extent. But you got much more freedom to go forth and start achieving those. Obviously, you got to do some work, no doubt. But we make it easier. We bring you to the starting line and we give you the direction using these tools.
So, because of Tony Robbins and other people, NLP has been used, this terminology has been used widely by so many people already. So according to you, how popular is NLP right now? You know, compared to what you have seen 3-4 years back or 10 years back, how is NLP standing right now?
NLP is quite popular, and I don't know how many qualified people are there who can give results, right? There are people like Tony Robbins, and a lot of people have learned what we found out, because I learned NLP in 2003. My role model was Tony Robbins. And that time I was in US, I was fascinated. A person who was a janitor can become a multi-millionaire, multi-billionaire. So I said, like, okay, I want what this guy has in terms of impacting so many billions of people. And the challenge was not simple. Challenge was pretty high for me when I learned. I had to overcome my own challenges, my own beliefs. And on top of it, I also overcame my problems. In terms of position where I was, in terms of my own earlier programming, where I didn't clear sixth standard, so I had to repeat sixth standard. So there are a lot of failures in different areas, which I used NLP and other tools to overcome those challenges and became fairly successful.
So if we talk, and if let's assume we had to discuss this, that which are the major problems you see, but see, your age, my age has a lot of difference. No? So if you compare your age with my age or your experience or you're at my age at that time. So compared to your generation and our generation, what kind of difference in challenge you are watching right now? What is the mindset difference or challenge difference? What are the problems which are there more right now compared to what you have seen in your era?
Right. One of the problems which I've seen is there was some acceptance in my generation. Acceptance of whatever was there. If there was no money, you accepted that fact. And you are willing to work towards improving your status and so on and so forth. In other words, to put it simply, we faced quite a few failures. We didn't take it for granted. But whereas the present generation, I wouldn't say that all, I would say like quite a significant amount of percentage, they want instant gratification. They want money. Sometimes they even go to shortcuts. They don't wait.
Wait, what is it? What do you mean by shortcuts?
See, they want happiness, let's say. There could be drugs. That is one possibility. Or they want to make money. So not all are interested in waiting. So maybe money at any cost. That could be one of the possibilities.
Do you think the policies of government are responsible for that? You know, I feel like, you know, the way the economy is shaping up, the way banks and other people are doing the business, that has been an instrument in terms of for example, now there are low-cost EMI, zero-cost EMI. You know, it's like they are forcing to buy us the things because everybody wants to have cool gadgets around them because it's like they want to have the instant gratification of handling that particular thing. So now this, because of this attractive offer, exclusive offer, or, you know, the kind of offer they make, it's easy for you to get the credit card and then low-cost EMI or zero-cost EMI, no EMI in this kind of thing, these kind of schemes. So it's like to push the economy higher, the kind of reforms government is doing, the kind of things government is pushing. Do you think this is one of the reasons for this generation to be like, you know, bad the way they are right now? It's easy to get money, easy to get leverage on money as well.
True. One is that I wouldn't say that the government is 100% responsible. Obviously, the government also looks at what is possible. Because I've been in US, I've been in UK, I've seen India also. Even in UK, drinking is a major problem. The majority of the youngsters, they stay at the pub and spoil their health. So unfortunately, what happens is like the education that we get, US, UK, even India, they don't teach us how to make money. They don't teach us how to create relationships, right? So the most important thing is relationship, making money, and living a happy life. So all these areas, we don't get educated. So
yeah, I agree to what you are saying. Traditional education is not focusing on how you can be a happy person. Instead of, they are more focused about how you can remember things.
Correct.
How you can do the rectification of whatever they are going to teach. And they want to install the similar kind of beliefs which they have about the things into you. So this is another, you know, social norms. The way they think is what you are also supposed to think. So that is the reason that they teach you, you know, everything which they know. Instead of asking you to explore about the things which they do not know. But coming back to this financial challenge in today's world, again, see, what I feel like the one aspect is of the government policies. Another aspect, if you see the kind of social pressure is there, no? Social pressure, which has been created by centuries now. And now it's like, see, a person, if you observe the way a normal human being is living right now, what happens? He goes to the good school, gets a fair reasonable grades, get a job, get married, buy a house, raise the kids, and by the time he realizes that he has forgot to live the life, he is closer to the grave. Okay, so if you observe the kind of financial structure has been made in India right now, or across the world for that matter, they have this kind of ads, this kind of strategic decisions, or it's like comfort. For example, if you want to buy a house in your era, it was very difficult. Unless until you have good money, solid money, you cannot buy a house of 30-40 lakhs, which is 30-40 lakhs or 50 lakhs house. It was a luxury, and it's kind of the rich and most rich people will have that kind of house at that time. But because of this software and other people, the boom software industry had, salary was good for a lot of people. So it was easy for them to get the loan from the bank. And because they had the security in their mind about getting a similar hike or similar kind of money, they won't wait for it. But the moment the bank and other people raised, the rates of the land and houses went up, it was pressure for the other sector, which was not having a similar kind of income. But still, they waited for that because their colleague, their friend, or somebody known to them was also going for the similar thing. So it's a kind of social pressure right now. What I have seen, this is a sad thing, but people are going crazy to look good on Facebook profile. They do all kind of editing, this and that, and they want to show something to the audience which is not very real.
True.
All the time they are trying to, they have cool gadgets, cool clothes, and they want to speak in style. Everything is there without the substance. So social norm, then social pressure, government policies, banking sector, the ads, advertisement department, everything is like they are not caring enough towards the well-being of the society or well-being of the human being. Instead of they are everybody. For example, you if you are aware about the Bajaj FinServ, these people give the loans like this, quick loans. Not only Bajaj, a lot of people are giving quick loans with minimum document, with no document, only salary proof is needed. So because they know once this person gets into their trap of spending without earning, this person will pay for the lifetime. They don't they are not aware of what kind of emotional trauma, mental trauma this person will go through. And this is a major challenge in today's world, because the kind of news I hear and the kind of interaction I have with the banking people, I come from the banking sector basically. So 70-80% of the people are suffering from this particular challenge of not being able to manage finances. And if you talk the symbolic language, it's, in other words, not being able to manage emotions as well.
Exactly.
So the another reason why people are becoming like this is because of less human interaction.
Correct.
In your era, people were used to talk, meet, hug, eat together. Right now, in one bedroom, husband and wife are not talking to each other. In one hall, husband and wife are not, let go the friends and other people. They are not meeting. That is a different part. But the communication is so less with the human that emotional challenge, emotional problems, and that problems getting manifested in terms of mental and the finance is just another, unavoidable thing, right?
See, the biggest thing which I saw is I agree completely. Because we had true friends, physical, where you could go and meet them, go around. And in fact, I remember hardly seeing any TV. In fact, when the TV came, very first time, at that time I was in Chennai, we used to take a walk to the beach almost every day. Because we didn't want to get caught up in looking at the TV. So what I was also thinking was, you had so many years of struggle in building up your business, right? So you've learned a lot. I got about 30 years of experience in corporate world. I was a senior delivery manager for IBM. And I've seen quite a few countries and so on and so forth. So what our clients would get is a combined experience of these two, so that they can shorten their span, because they might have the environment where they will get the insights and also the wisdom that we both have. So this is the biggest plus point which they can use to not only accelerate their life, to also avoid the pitfalls in terms of the mistakes.
Great. So the, for the people who joined late, let me make you aware that we are having this program on 27th and 28th of this month, wherein we are going to teach the therapy of graphology and NLP. And we will put you through that therapy to resolve your issues in terms of health, wealth, mindset, emotions, relationship, you know, you name it. And we will be incorporating all those things to solve your issues. So when I say NLP, people are a bit confused. That is what I feel like. You know, a lot of people who have not experienced it or who have not gone through it are not completely, it's like a jargon for them, NLP, NLP, NLP. So how exactly NLP works, you know, how, what a NLP practitioner does or NLP master does to a person, and what happens, how that problem gets resolved in their life.
Right. See, I'll use a computer analogy. Imagine that we got a laptop or a desktop where you got different files in different areas. So the emotion is the key which gives life to these incidences in our life, which affect us in a major way. So what we basically do is, imagine that there are likes and dislikes. So let's say, imagine that all the things that you like are in a particular directory, files. All the things that you dislike are in a different directory. So if I remove one of the files from the dislikes to likes, things can have a different reaction in you. For example, to be healthy, let's say like you need to eat a lot of vegetables and you don't like vegetables, you dislike vegetables. So we can easily make this shift at the subconscious level by doing a simple exercise. Whereas initially when you didn't like something and then you started liking it, and initially you had some challenge. For example, two of my friends, colleagues in IBM, they had a travel sickness, right? And this travel sickness was there for one person, it was there for 5 or 6 years. Another person, it was there for 10 years. Both of them, I did an exercise, NLP exercise, for about 30, 35 minutes. And immediately after that, within a month, they both traveled to Bangalore. For the first time in their life, they're free to travel without taking any tablets, without going hungry. They could eat, they could relax, and they were trouble free. So something that can be there for 5, 6 years or 10 years goes away like that. How valuable is that?
This is awesome. So again, you know, let's assume a person has financial trauma. He's not able to gain wealth. He's not able to earn much more money. And that is impacting his life. He's not having a good relationship with the wife because of lack of this money and always under pressure. So if we use NLP technique on him, and we give him the program of abundance, in how many days or month or what exactly will happen to him now? What he will be able to achieve?
See, as I told you, basically, like, let's imagine that like you are pulling with one hand and you're pulling on the opposite direction with another hand. So you are kind of at a stalemate. So what we do is like use NLP to open some of these gates so that there is less pull and then the hand travels towards the direction of your goal. So it can happen very quickly. In fact, I had one client, for 2 years, he was not getting any progress in his career. With one session with me, immediately his name was added to the next promotion list, right? So things can happen very quickly. Maybe a couple of weeks, people can see the difference. The lack of financial abundance has got to do with tension, basically, and lack of ability to kind of look at the opportunities, catch those opportunities, maybe risk-taking ability. So some of these, they also include a little bit of creativity. So when we are more creative, when we are tension-free. So the tension itself adds to that. What we can remove is like using some of these exercises, bring the person to a balanced state of mind and pick up some qualities from the role model that you like in whatever area. Maybe it could be wealth, maybe it could be emotional resilience, or maybe emotional control, balance, joy, happiness, whatever you take. We can bring you towards a starting line in the sense like we can remove some of the factors that pull you back, and we can program your future, because all the unnecessary junk is to a greater degree cleared.
So it's like
short answer is magic, right? 2 to 3 weeks.
Yeah. So it's like magic, basically. I have also tried NLP, and it works. You know, within 2-3 sittings, you change completely, and it manifests in a beautiful way. So actually, see, ultimately, you will have to put efforts. You know, nobody is going to replace your efforts, your working style, or your knowledge and all. But what it will do, it will open the gates, as Ganesh said, it will open the gates through which it will be easy for you to flow. The flow will be smooth. What you will have to do, it's magic in terms of the opening of your possibilities of your mind. You know, your mind will start believing in those ideas. It's like let's assume there was one client to which I had given this scientific logo, and it's like he wanted to go for 500 crores turnover. So now, going to 500 crores turnover, he need to have a different kind of mindset. With the same mindset which he has right now, it will be very difficult for him to reach to that level. So the easiest way is to reprogram his mind and put this belief into his subconscious mind that it's possible, it's easy, and it's comfortable. So with this belief, it will be very easy for him to go into the market and look for the opportunity. I guess there is one movie regarding similar kind of concept, Inception. Have you heard about that movie, Inception?
Yeah.
So they also have this pill. They reprogram subconscious mind by going into the layers of dream, one layer, second layer, third layer, and they put it into deep subconscious mind, and person starts believing in that idea as true.
Let me ask you this question.
Yeah.
If I ask you, who are you? In terms of identity, let's not go to the deeply spiritual level. If I ask you, who are you? You will say like, okay, I'm a businessman. You'll talk about all the other stuff that you have done so far. So basically our identity, how does it get formed?
This is accumulation of experiences.
Accumulation of experiences and the interpretation that you make. For example, when you are in fifth standard, let's say, your maths teacher comes and says, man, you are a genius in mathematics. So you accept, because they are authority figures. They are like God, right?
Okay.
Same way, if the science teacher says, you're no good in science, I'll accept it. That was a wrong assumption. Because one person says something, we accept. So whatever happens to us, accidentally or planned one, irrespective of what the person says, it is how we perceive at that young age, without much of an intelligence, without much of wisdom, that determines our current condition.
Correct.
There's absolutely no basis for that. So based on that, we have built a belief and put so many factors, like we have seen proof for this particular belief. Now, with NLP, what we can do is we can create the opposite belief. Let's say like you are poor, and you can create a belief that you are rich and remove all the legs from the poor belief and add additional legs to the rich belief. So, of course, it's going to take some time for you to gain more stability in that particular belief. And of course, you got to take some actions, no doubt. But definitely, we can remove this. We can reinstall a new belief. It is as simple as doing a couple of exercises.
So you have learned both the sciences, graphology as well as NLP. And if somebody wants to know that whether he should go for the NLP as a career or graphology as a career, what will be your suggestion? You know, which kind of people should go for the NLP, and which kind of people should go for the graphology as a career? I'm asking.
Right. See, some of the qualities are required in both the cases. For example, your communication needs to be really good, and you should like and enjoy working with people. Right. In graphology, there is more of an analysis. A person who is very well suited for analysis, they can choose graphology because they like to study. It's more like a detective. You got to look at the signs. You got to be very, very detail oriented, right? In NLP, you like to work with people. Again, you're using communication. Your communication is a key, because half the things happen because how you say things in NLP. And part of the component is also having a hypnotic script. Not necessarily you might take them through hypnosis, but the skill in that area is really helpful in NLP. So depending on these two, where you are at, would you like to look at different handwriting and do a lot of analysis? And you got to be sharp in both the areas, right? Noticing that. And genuinely, you should be interested in people, working with people in both
areas. That goes in any other business. Now, let me tell you, the kind of experience I had with business people is like, the person who is more compassionate, more loving, has always, about earning money, it's a knack. You need, nothing can replace that. But other than that, if a person is very, very successful, let's say, that person will always have this quality that he is good with the people. He is compassionate and he understands the value of life. He understands the value of emotions. So without having this kind of understanding, nobody can earn money. Nobody can be very successful. Nobody can have good relationship with other people, other person. So, you know, bearing those, what I understood from your point of view, who is like the person who is having more of a keen, I or who is very, very analytical in nature, that person is more suited for the graphology.
Correct.
Right? And whereas NLP is like, other than the qualities which are required for a good businessman or good entrepreneur or good human being, I always believe that good entrepreneur is always a good human being, because unless and until you are good with the human people or humanity, it's very difficult for you to grow as a businessman or entrepreneur as well. So besides those qualities, it's like what extra factor, you know, NLP person has, you know, it's like, I know astrologers, I know numerologists, I know Vastu experts as well, you know. So it's like the people who are engineers in terms of interior designing or civil engineers, those people go for the Vastu most of the cases. Numerologists are the people who, to be honest, numerology is a small segment compared to the vastness of Vastu and astrology. So it's like the people who are good with numbers, wants to enjoy and very jolly in nature, you know, because it's numbers. So the moment you talk about numbers, numbers are quick, fast. You know, wherever numbers will come, the speed is more. It's like the numbers keeps you in present. They don't allow you to go into the future or go into the past. So the people who are more of a, if you talk about in the language of graphology, the people who are more of middle zone kind of people, no, middle zone, the people who are having middle zone as dominant, those people will be usually good with the numbers, and those people will go for the numerology. So when it comes to the NLP, which are those people who like NLP the most, or who become gets fascinated with the NLP? What is the typical?
The top zone. The people who are the top zone, who are generally thinkers. So, and even middle zone. Middle zone, because like people want to enjoy life more. So they also come. So all type of people come, but the people who do NLP program are generally, I've seen, mostly thinkers, because even though we said like analytical thinking is good for graphology, here your observational power needs to be really good, because you got to look at how the person behaves, what kind of signals the person is giving through his face, through his body, through the words, and so on and so forth. So at the same time, many levels of communication are happening.
Oh, so you meant to say, just because you know the NLP tricks, techniques, it doesn't make you, it doesn't guarantee you the success in terms of the, as a therapist, right?
Exactly. So it's easy to, what you call, receive NLP. So I can go and attend a session. There'll be transformation in me. But if I have to go and deliver it to somebody else, so you need to have a few skills, extra skills, which I learned, because in my own group, there were 20, 30 people who did NLP practitioner. Of course, there was change in almost like everybody. But very few people like started applying it on others. I was one of the few who started applying left, right, and center, because I had a burning thirst in me. So I wanted to use this tool to help others, right? Because I was looking for a tool, because looking at my own background, where I wanted people to enjoy studying, right? And I was not given that opportunity because of the system and so on and so forth. So when I was looking for that, when I saw Tony Robbins, I said like, wow, this is a tool that I want to learn. So I came back to India in 1999, end of 1999, and started looking for a trainer. And then I found a trainer in Keki Darbari within Pune. Then there was no stopping for the time.
So if I want to relate my story, which is like you went for other people to help. It's like you had this burning desire to help people. If you guys are not aware, he's from IIT Kanpur, right?
Varanasi.
IIT Varanasi, BHU. Okay, so sorry. So it's like now, he had this burning desire to help other people. When I learned graphology, I myself was struggling a lot. I had so many challenges of my own. So initially, I learned it for fun. You know, it's like I learned it from the books initially, and I saw the girls were crazy about it. So I had this huge queue of girls who will be waiting for me to get their handwriting analyzed. So it was very fun. You know, you imagine a guy at the age of 21, 22, and, you know, girls falling over for doing their analysis. It was dream coming true. But inside me was not happy. You know, it's like I knew that I'm not at that level. The analysis is not that great. So I had this burning desire to learn more. So I learned graphology to help myself first. And when it gave me results, there I said, wow, if a guy like me can achieve this kind of thing, then why not to go and help other people who are like me, or, you know, at times not better than me. In that way, I started teaching to other people. So basically, the helping nature was always there, and we are looking for a tool. And it's like you are, it's your destiny most of the time. Many of you are not aware about your destiny part. So what I feel like, you know, your destiny is always pushing you towards your own self or your passion or your, it's like, if you, yesterday, few days back, only one person asked me this question, okay, that how can I solve my issue, this very unique issue, that that girl is approximately 40 plus and she's not yet married. And that question was that, how can I get married, or how can I solve this issue of my life? You know, everything is okay, everything is great. So while answering to her question, no, I thought, you know, this, she has a lot of challenges other than this as well. So what I realized is, the moment you go for your destiny, the moment you do something for which you are made up of, the moment you do something for which universe has created you, it's like you are fulfilling your destiny. And if you are doing, if you are fulfilling your destiny, if you are doing something passionately, or you are performing something in your passion, then entire universe helps you out and solves all your issues. It's like if you are bad in the marketing and you are, if you are passionate, some marketing person will teach you marketing, or somebody will join your organization. If you're bad with communication, somebody will come and teach you communication, or he will handle your communication. So the right thing to do to solve all your problems is to go for your passion. If you are passionate about something, stop everything. Be sensible while doing it. Have some money back up, but go for it, because it is going to solve all the challenges of your life. Ganesh, what do you have to say about this?
Exactly. See, what I'm also saying to the people who are listening to this is, come without any agenda, only the burning desire to resolve your issues. Come with an issue. Check this out. If you enjoy this and you want to make it as your career, go ahead. Otherwise, you'll definitely get results for your own life, wherever you want to go.
And so, if just to interrupt you, if I want to pinpoint your expertise, okay, this is the area you have solved. This is, for example, in my case, I'm good with entrepreneurs, especially manufacturing industry, something I have given good results already. So that is a niche for me. What about you? Which particular target segment you have been, you know, miraculous in terms of results?
For anybody, I started with students initially. Then I started working with all the other people, like all segments. Cleaning up the past is my specialty. Whatever is your issue related to the past, however bad it might be, it will look like a story to you.
So again, when you say issues in the past, but what kind of problems you have solved in the past related
abuses,
problems?
Sexual abuse, trauma, fear, worry, tension, money problems, relationship issues. Everything comes from the past. We carry our baggage and we assume that my past doesn't have any relevance. But whether we like it or not, the past has got a major relevance. And the only way to do that is use some of the tools and technology like NLP or deep breathing, holotropic breathing, meditation, so many ways. But NLP is the easiest, where you don't have to do anything. We help you to reconfigure, restructure the past and clean up.
So you have been helping so many people already. So when you talk to people, what are the major challenges the current era is facing, or current generation, or current people to whomever you are giving the therapy right now? What are the major challenges people are coming up with?
One is the mental resilience. Right? Emotional resilience, that is less. So that generally they want to change. Right? Mm-hmm. So they get upset and they're not able to watch it like a third person or even second person. They get so involved. So you get people with anger problems, emotional issues, and they're not able to control themselves. Maybe it's food, maybe addictions. So all these areas, the solution is bring more awareness, bring more mindfulness.
So a lot of people are coming to you with the emotional traumas, emotional issues.
Yeah, emotional issues. Right.
So meanwhile, we have been asked one question on Facebook. The question is, graphology word is alien to many people even today. Yeah, very true. How did you, at such early age, got to know of this subject? Okay, so if I want to make you aware about the guru of mine, that guru is he's a champ. He's excellent in graphology. So I have learned this from Milind Rajore. I was with him for 10 long years. So it's like I dedicated my entire life to learning it, you know, whatever was there after the college. And I was so passionate that about it that whenever there was a chance to travel with sir or to go to some areas where he was doing analysis or some events were there where we used to stand and do the analysis and all those things, be it IIT Mumbai or, you know, going to smaller sections of these events and all. So we did all, you know, going to RBI for that matter. We went to RBI for making them aware about the graphology. So because of such huge exposure to graphology, because I was doing graphology with very, very successful person who was in the industry from last maybe 20 years. So because he was having such a huge exposure, because he started the work when there was nothing about graphology. So he invariably got a lot of recognition because he was the only person. So when I started working with him, because of his exposure, I got the exposure, you know, without sweating. And because of this kind of exposure, it was easy for me to learn a lot of things which other people are not being able to learn. So it's like I have given a lot of time, more than 10 years I was with my mentor to master this, and then I did my own research as well. I went to Nashik, where there is one person of one friend of mine, Paresh Chitnis. Initially, I taught to his students. I went to Mumbai. There, I also did some kind of workshop. I taught. And I had this passion. Then there were incidents like, you know, I went to a lot of spiritual programs. Maybe Isha, Shiv Yog, or, you know, there were plenty of people doing NLP. Not NLP, Reiki and also. Because of such huge exposure related to this area. And I had this passion. And I had this time of entire world to put into. It kind of evolved along the way, especially during those 7 years of my journey of as an entrepreneur. There, I got a chance to meet 10 people every single day. And there, I analyzed their handwriting and the logo, and I became master because of that exposure. So you imagine 10 per day, it means it will be 300 per month multiplied by the number of years, 7 years, you know, 7 years, 12 months. So the number is huge. More than 25,000 people I have met already. So because of this exposure, I became good at what I do. Yeah. So this was a question asked by Digvijay Singh. Yeah, Ganesh. So it's nice. It's nice when we discuss about the NLP, the kind of miracles NLP can do. So what are the limitations of NLP? Because graphology also has got a lot of limitations. So according to you, what are the limitations of this NLP?
See, one is people expect like everything will come in their platter, right? They have to do the work. Again, the analogy is like a race. Race, normally what happens, like people start at the starting line, and when the gun is fired, everybody starts running at the same time. But compared to a running race, some people are not even aware that race is happening in their own life. So they are elsewhere. Some people are like way ahead of the starting line. So they will take some time to even come to the starting line. Some people are in the wrong direction. They are at the starting line, but standing in the opposite direction. So when the race starts, they go quickly in the opposite direction. So these are the different challenges that people have. So the mindset that, okay, yes, I will get some help, no doubt, but I'm willing to do whatever it takes to get to achieve my result. So come with an open mind, right? And most of the challenges, definitely there'll be an improvement, no doubt. The only case where it may not work is when your destiny is elsewhere. Even there, you will get to know it pretty quickly.
This is good. Another thing is, any funny incidences you remember, you know, when you gave therapy or you were learning NLP, what kind of funny incidences you can share with us? We know that you are not very funny man. You don't share many jokes. There's a chance that people might get to know about your funny side as well.
Funny side. Yeah, it's not funny. It is like always people didn't know that the tool was available. So one guy had a issue with exam fear. He didn't even know that NLP could help him. For 10 years, he had been suffering. Every time exam comes, he'll always be in the bathroom. So much tension and anxiety. With one sitting, within 15, 20 minutes, his anxiety was gone. And thereafter, he started writing the exams pretty in a calm fashion. So I don't recollect anything funny, but it's basically joyful. The experience is joyful.
I will share some experience of mine. Before that, Colonel Digvijay Singh is asking you one question. For a person interested in NLP and get insight in the field, what is your advice and on how one should begin, grow, and become knowledgeable and on process? It's like the question. What is your advice?
Yeah, start doing the practitioner. Start doing the practitioner and start practicing it on others.
Okay.
So the more the practice, the more fun you will have. And more fun, the persons who are undergoing that. And once you start getting results, because like so many times, even when I did it really badly, right? Mm-hmm. I learned a lot. Particularly, I learned a lot when my experiments and my trials went totally wrong, right?
Oh, same here.
So that's the time you learn most. And you also gain confidence. Because once I had so much of experience in that, once I was watching my friend doing a timeline exercise. Mm-hmm. So as he was taking him through the timeline, this guy went to his past. And at that past, this guy was having a attack of flu or something. So when this friend of mine was taking that guy and he started exhibiting the symptoms of the flu now.
Oh.
My friend got literally jittery.
Yeah, of course.
He was just didn't know what to do. Then immediately I stepped in and said like, okay, but you are safe now. Bring on this power and energy. And then immediately I took him out of that state. So that's really funny, but you have the power actually to recreate anything at will and bring them on. But this confidence came because of my experiences, failures, and successes.
So in my case, talking about funny stories, it's like I gave the signature to one person, signature therapy. And he went outside, he practiced for 10 minutes. He came back and he said, okay, now my problems will get solved, right? From tomorrow onwards, there will be no problem. So like this, and you know, a lot of funny incidences are there where even if I tell people to do a signature,
right,
you know, a particular kind of signature, they do their own all the way and come back and say, ki, we are doing the similar signature like what you have said. So that is that thing is also there. Most of the time people are not aware at all about how minutely they need to observe and do the signature or do the handwriting changes. So so plenty of such instances where a person, even if I ask him to write slow, they are not writing it slow, and so many things. At times they call me anytime and ask me suggestions on the areas of marriage or land or so many areas where I don't have any expertise, right? But because we have solved one problem of there from the handwriting or the graphology or the logo designing, they feel like we are like God and can solve any of their problems. So this is another a lot of funny incidents like that also have happened in my life in terms of the therapy part. Yeah. So Ganesh, anything more you want to add or ask?
I would say, irrespective of whether it's NLP or graphology, enjoy the process. Enjoy your day-to-day activities. So if you gain something more, treat it like a bonus. So don't be pent up on saying, like, okay, I have to do this X, Y, Z. Only this is success. Success will come. But in the meantime, enjoy the process. Make your own share of mistakes. Because a plant, when it grows, we don't expect the fruits and everything else right in the beginning. We expect the plant to grow. Take your own time, because you didn't become an expert in a day, right? You took so many years.
Yeah, 14 years, 14 nonstop years of, still I feel like a rookie now. I want to learn more. Yeah.
2003, I started my NLP journey, started learning and so on and so forth. I went through so many trainings. In fact, I would have spent a fortune on all my trainings, because I enjoyed the trainings. Mm. And now I've started applying my trainings. So nothing has gone waste. So whatever I've learned, even though I'm fully utilized all my skills, but I've started using it now.
This is great. And I don't know how many people will be involved till this point, but there are three, four people are still watching. So for you, we are having this session of NLP plus graphology during 27th and 28th of this month. Don't miss this chance. Learn something unique. Go through the process. Improve. And this will be the online course. Online, we and me and Ganesh will be conducting this course. We will teach you few stuff, and we will also put you through some therapy. You know, I will be giving a graphotherapy. Ganesh will be giving the NLP, and we will also make you aware about what kind of changes we are expecting in you. And since we are both are teaming up for the first time like this, the charges are very, very few, you know, very, very nominal. It's like very few dollars or few rupees, both are fine. You know? And the investment is very nominal for you to experience the expertise of both the people. So if you are willing to go for it, there are numbers on my Facebook page, his Facebook page. Mine will be 97652261827, and you can connect us, and we will make you aware about what is the process. Yeah.
Great. I enjoyed. All we can promise is, like, there'll be a lot of fun. You'll enjoy the whole course, and you'll get transformed in those 2 days.
Great. So, guys, thank you very much for watching, and we will be meeting you soon again like this. We will be having more questions regarding graphology, NLP together. Might be, you know, day after tomorrow or, you know, 2-3 days after, we will be again coming online like this, and we'll be more discussing more about NLP and grapho, how to combine together. You know, I also will give you tips about how numerology and grapho are connected. I have been able to discover those secrets, and I will be discussing, because Ganesh, if you are not aware, he is a numerologist as well now. So he's a graphologist, numerologist, NLP practitioner. So we will be discussing that aspect of numerology and graphology in coming videos. So stay tuned. And if you really like the way we have conducted this session, please do share, comment, like, and encourage us to share more information with you. Thank you very much. Good night. Shabba khair.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye. Bye. Bye.